this is Cher. And if you've been watching my videos, I've shown you a lot of ways to use essential oils, and I've talked a lot about what essential oils can do. Today I'd like to discuss something a little different. What not to do with essential oils and what essential oils just can't do. So you're gonna hear a lot of misleading claims, usually from people that want to sell you overpriced essential oils, mainly multi-level marketing companies. There's two big ones and they both really overcharge, but another problem is that they have a lot of bad advice and misleading claims. So I wanted to talk a little bit about what not to do. First of all, don't ingest essential oils. They're really powerful. Any experienced aromatherapist will tell you to use them for external use. Now, there are exceptions where essential oils are used in food. For instance, I worked for a company that made soda and they'd use orange essential oil in their soda. But you've got to understand, they were making whole tanks of soda at a time and adding just, you know, the smallest amount of the oil, so it was super diluted. If you put two drops of orange oil in water or something, it's going to be a lot different because, first of all, there's nothing like sugar or something else to hold the essential oils down, so you're going to get them all in one gulp at the beginning, and you could burn your mouth, your skin. It's just not a good idea, so I'll leave it at that. For home use, do not ingest essential oils. Don't cook with them. Don't put them in water for a variety of reasons, but just don't do it. Secondly, never use essential oils undiluted, especially if it's something you don't know a lot about. I hear a lot of just apply things neat to an area. You could get really bad skin sensitivities from doing that. And a skin sensitivity is something that could build up over time from too much contact with one oil. So really follow dilution guidelines when you're working with essential oils. Thirdly, never use harsh oils when you're working with children. I'll go further when you're working with children, the elderly, or people with very sensitive skin. Don't ever use things like clove, the spices, eucalyptus, peppermint on their skin, and also don't expose them to large portions of it by a diffuser. I'm sure if, you know, a kid walked in a room and it smelled a little bit like eucalyptus and then walked out, they'd be fine. Might make them feel a little bit more awake, but if it's in their bedroom 24/7, that could build up. It could cause asthma problems in people with asthma. So don't use oils undiluted, and I guess I also merged into that, don't diffuse 24/7. I mean, diffuse for an hour if you want a little relaxation, but then stop diffusing. You don't need it 24/7. People just want to sell you more oil, so they'll say put it in your food, diffuse it all day in this heavy diffuser. Don't do it. With essential oils, less is more. Also, you've got to be careful if you've got pets, especially cats. I mean, a lot of essential oils are very dangerous for cats and could be for dogs. Now, I do sometimes make dog shampoos with essential oils, but number one, they're diluted. Number two, they're washed off. It's not something the dog's going to be licking up. So you have to be very careful if you have pets. You know, I'll drop essential oils in my sink and stuff to keep to keep pests away. But if you've got a cat, you can't do that because they could get up there and lick that. So you've got to use common sense and guidelines. Okay, now what essential oils cannot do? They cannot cure cancer. They cannot shrink tumors. They don't cure Ebola. They won't cure Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, Huntington's. They won't completely turn around a kid with ADHD. I mean, certainly some symptoms you're having when you're facing large illnesses could be dealt with aromatherapy. Sometimes a nausea could be helped by smelling certain essential oils that help with nausea. Sometimes, if you're just feeling very nervous, sometimes aromatherapy could help, but then you're going to have to choose very gentle oils and be especially careful because people with serious illnesses may have more sensitivity. So you've got to be really careful about what you think essential oils can do. You have to always go to your medical doctor if you think you have an infection, because essential oils can be antivirals and it can be antibacterials, but the ones that are strong for that are going to be harsh on your skin. You're not going to want to ingest them. Go to the doctor for the stronger meds. You could use essential oils to protect yourself, to clean your home with, to maybe spray in the air, to try and kill some of the germs in the air. But once you've got that infection, you've got to go to the doctor. Also, never use essential oils in open wounds, on mucous membranes, in your eyes. Lots of common sense stuff. So, I mean, that's really all I wanted to say today. Beware of those trying to sell you essential oils. Using essential oils to make your own product should save you money. You should be spending about 10% of what you'd be spending on pre-made products by making your own. If those oils are marked up 35%, though, that's not going to happen. So that's all I had to say. I hope you guys have a great day and peace.